Watch out, vehicle on shoulder ahead.
Underway at a site where an oil tank platform collapsed in Jeroboam Bay, Louisiana. County estimates that less than 14,000 gallons spilled the cause being investigated. This is CBS News.
Liberty Mutual customizes your car and home insurance, so you only pay for what you need. Visit libertymutual.com to learn more. Information about the off-duty Monterey Park police officer who was shot to death yesterday in Downey. He'd only been an officer a matter of days.
The Downey Police Department is investigating the shooting that happened in this city outside of a gym. Monterey Park Police Chief Kelly Gordon confirms the identity of her murdered off-duty officer killed in this attack.
Gordio was hired by the Monterey Park Police Department as a police officer recruit January 31st of this year. He graduated from the academy on July 22nd, at which point he went from recruit to police officer and started his field training program on July 26th.
So many questions about a motive in the shooting, about a possible suspect or suspects. The Downey Police Department says investigators following up on numerous leads, nothing being released. At this time, in Downey, Craig Victor, KNX News, 97.1 FM.
Up on town, and Trick Kid into sending him child porn via messaging app. Now he's heading to prison for a long time.
The way that he was operating the sophistication and his preying upon young people is what convinced the judge in the case to lock him up for 25 years in federal prison.
U.S. Attorney's Office spokesperson Tom Rozek says Jonathan Garcia posed as a 15-year-old boy
and offered a 9-year-old Ontario girl pornographic video. Her mother found out, called police. They raided his home and found he'd done this before.
Collector is here obtaining images from victims that he met online, but also downloading images of child pornography that he appears to carefully catalog on various electronic devices.
Peter Saber admitted to contact that his girls online for child pornography and they got him.
If you're a night owl, new paper explains why you should get to bed before the clock strikes midnight. And, sounds like a horror movie premise, but Spider Corp robots are real. We will tell you what they're doing.
So what happens if you stay up past midnight?
You turn into a pumpkin.
Pumpkin.
Yeah.
What happens?
Mm-hmm.
So
scientifically proven.
Okay. We start, though, with upcoming retirement of tennis star Serena Williams. With us is Rick Macy, longtime Hall of Fame tennis coach who coached Serena and her sister Venus when they were younger. And Doug Smith is with us, award-winning tennis writer and author of Whirlwind, The Godfather of Black Tennis, which is a biography of Dr. Robert Walter Johnson. Both of you, thank you for being with us. Rick, let's start off with you. Are you at all surprised by her comments and posts?
No, you know, listen, it's her terms. What an amazing career. You know, she has a lot of stuff going on. You know, she's a mother. She's doing it her way. You know, she won her first Grand Slam at the U.S. Open, and she's going to call it a day there, and I think it's going to be beyond epic. So as long as she's happy, this is what happens with athletes, and I'm glad she's doing it on her terms, and there's not an injury, and that's the most important thing.
There's a lot of lines to stick out in the piece, though. One of them is, you know, she kind of had to make this decision a few times for herself. She was saying, you know, it was like a taboo topic, even in her own head. She said it would come up, I would start to cry. How hard do you think it was for her to realize and, you know, tell herself that, you know what, I don't want to, but it's time.
No, especially when you're going to go down as the greatest female tennis player ever to hold a racket. Serena's wired different. You know, when you're at the mountaintop, they're going to go down as a ghost. You got to understand, you're one of the most brutal, intense competitors ever, and she loves the stage, loves the competition, she loves the crowd, she's a performer, just like Jordan and all these others that are the best of the best. So this was very, very difficult, but at the end of the day,
watch out, vehicle on shoulder ahead.
She played through postpartum depression. I mean, she was playing through all of these things that she was dealing with.
Well, yeah, the most felt so well about her when Venus reached the final U.S. Open, and she had to feel like this should be her. I watched Serena. She was on the sideline watching her sister, her big sister, do this. And it was clear to me that this is something she really wanted. So a couple of years later, she goes ahead and beat Martina Hingis in the 1999 U.S. Open, I believe it was. And after that, it was Serena just about all of the time.
Rick, I'm curious, if you were to be teaching a youngster now in playing tennis, is there something from Serena Williams that you could sort of take as an example that you would want to impart to somebody learning the game or at least trying to perfect the game?
Well, first off, a great question. You know, listen, when I went out there in 1999, you know, at first I didn't see it. You know, I had best vacation ever took. Who would say it's tough in California? But, you know, I didn't see it at first. But there was a rage. There was a burning rage. Not just in Serena, but in Venus. It's what I saw under the hood, that they were bulletproof. And this was baked in extra crispy for her, I'm telling you. And, you know, they needed an opportunity, which I gave them, and they just needed experience. Because when you have just a brutal, brutal competitor, like women's tennis has never seen, everybody's competitive, this was another level. I never seen two little kids, especially her Serena, trying so hard to get to a ball. She would almost fall down. And you know, when you have that, when the fans are in the stands and it's showtime, that's priceless. And sure, I talk to the kids all about that. And I've had many others that have them qualities, but especially with Serena, she checked every box and she actually created a few more.
Smith, award-winning tennis writer.
And when we come back, it's the FBI versus Donald Trump. Who wins that one?
Hey, Zach, what are we going to do if someone needs their drain cleared?
I'll send a drain technician to clear your drain for just $80.
$80 is a great price. Are they going to use a drain table?
Yep, an extra long $30.
Gill Air Conditioning and Plumbing, GOE, TPO.
Some internet companies make promises on speed they just can't deliver. Spectrum Internet offers true gig speed to more homes while delivering more consistent download speed, all with 99.9% network reliability. And our advanced home Wi-Fi gives customers more control and security. If it's connected, it's protected. We don't have to do online. You can do it better and faster. Learn more at Spectrum.com. Based on internet subscribers among top ISPs. Spectrum.com/reliability for details.
Watch out, vehicle on shoulder ahead.
Have retired in luxury on the beach in San Felipe, Baja, California. Did you know that the future of green technology is happening now on the beach in Baja, California? That you can own a beautiful sea view home for a fraction of what it would cost in the U.S.? Did you know that the cost of living is one quarter the cost of what it is here? Discover Rancho Costa Verde, an amazing cutting-edge green community on the beach at prices you haven't seen in your lifetime. Not a lease, not a timeshare. Ownership home sites with 180-degree sea views starting at only $22,500. With terms and financing that make it affordable for almost anyone. To attend a free informational dinner seminar in Los Angeles on August 1st, or in Tustin on August 17th, or in Riverside on August 24th, call 1-800-211-7400. Call 1-800-211-7400. 1-800-211-7400.
CHP to arrive there. On the 405, they've got road work.